The Quarto Group presents The Ultimate Guide to Channeling, Practical Techniques to Connect with Your Spirit Guides. Written by Amy Sikarskie, read by Ann Richardson. This book is dedicated to those who have sought out a deeper meaning to life and their connection with spirit through the art of intuitive communication. Through their practice, they have kept the tradition alive and present on the earth plane. I dedicate this book to all who are openly seeking, energetically awakening, and consciously pursuing a connection with their oversoul, guides, angels, and light family in spirit. May the messages, guidance, and shared insights support and heal you along your way. Introduction. Channeling is a form of communication with which we bring in energy from the non-physical realm and ground it into our reality. We connect with non-physical beings and allow their vibrations, emotions, thoughts, healing properties, and frequency to flow through us. These aspects can then be experienced by us and shared with others in the physical world. When you harness a frequency of life, thought, or specific vibration, and then express it through you, you are channeling. There are many channeling styles. Some people channel emotion and awareness through art, music, and poetry. Others may naturally channel through dance, singing, and storytelling. Connecting in the spirit realms for information is another form of channeling, as is working with healing frequencies to use in energy therapy. Channeling has been around for as long as we can remember. Humankind has weaved in and out of conscious and unconscious communication with guides, angels, and the spirit of the world around them. Over time, this relationship has strengthened or weakened based on factors such as community, religion, economy, and advancements in the modern age. As we step further away from spiritual communication and focus on other areas of human life, our connection can fade and weaken. Some gradually lose their conscious and defined connection, while others feel the calling and are directed back to a stronger relationship with spirit. In our soul-searching process, many of us have discovered that we are a part of something more than what we previously knew. We are physical and spiritual, and our essence expands beyond the focus of modern-day life here on Earth. In this book, we will discuss forms of channeling, sources of energy and information, steps to finding your preferred practice, and tips for creating a purposeful, safe, and beneficial relationship with your spirit guides. Insights shared come from my personal experiences and messages that I have received. Like many, and perhaps yourself, I was open to intuitive communication as a child, shut down for a few years, and then opened back up. Each chapter and season of my life has held a special connection with my guides and angels. As we move forward, you will hear me refer to this collective as my team. My team includes archangels. I have spoken with them weekly for years, and we have built a strong relationship. My team is also made up of my spirit guides. These are spirits in higher realms of creation who have insights, understandings, and an interest in my personal life. They have assisted me many times and in many ways. My guides have introduced me to a beautiful and very light-hearted group of star beings. These are spirits who do not call Earth their home planet. They span from many galaxies and places outside of Earth, having their incarnations in our and other solar systems. They are known as the Council of Light. This council body is here to support and assist the planet Earth and us. I have also worked with ascended masters, enlightened beings who once lived on Earth and arose or ascended to a higher plane of existence after spiritual transformation. And I have worked with elemental beings who live in other dimensions and are closely working with nature and the elements of the Earth. All provide information from their perspective and life experiences. Finding my connections. I remember when I was a little girl, I was pretty down and experienced a moment in which I was self-conscious, concerned, and sad about my physical appearance. I questioned if I was relatable, attractive, accepted by my community, loved, and able to have a bright future. I was around 9 or 10 years old and getting ready for bed when these thoughts and awareness came to me. Walking into my room, I sat down on my bed. Pondering, I suddenly felt a powerful and palpable energy come into my space. It felt very loving, warm, and soft. I could feel it wrapping around me, and I heard messages in my head telling me I was beautiful and loved, and that I would succeed in life. I would have a bright future and achieve goals. There were no specifics to these goals. Instead, I felt the enormity of life. I felt awareness that I would grow to be an adult, having friends and a family of my own. The energy then merged in with my heart, expanding my chakra with love. It was like a beautiful hug that I felt both internally and externally. All of my thoughts softened, and the energy of worry melted away. I felt a profound peace as my eyes gently welled up with warm tears. At this moment, I felt love, peace, protection, reassurance, and comfort. The presence around me felt natural and not at all out of the ordinary. I knew it was love from another realm, and I did not question this energy or seek to put a label or name on it. Through an assortment of senses, I felt a connection. I received strong and sure messages in my mind. I could hear words and sentences, while the emotions and understanding that came with them encompassed me. This experience was natural and an unexpected gift. I know now that at a young age, I was using my clairsenses. Our guides and angels have their own energies, and I can feel mine around me now. Yours are here as well, and perhaps you can feel them. Relax. Be open to the possibility and just be. Breathe, be, and observe. There is no right or wrong observation, and there is no judgment here. They may be close or they may be viewing, watching over you from a distance. Mine are very present here and would like to come through and speak with us now. Welcome to the world of channeling, where each practice and gift is uniquely its own. We are so happy that you are here with us today and welcome the opportunities to expand on and explore this ancient art of intuitive communication. We believe that it is not by chance that you were led here to these teachings, writings, and understandings. We are here to help you, and throughout these pages, to lead the way. It is our hopes and desires that you will find the messages within to be insightful and informative, and that they help you set the foundations for your own practice and process of tuning in with whichever streams of consciousness you desire. As you may have noticed, there are many here with you now. You are here, we are here, our partner Amy is here, and your team in spirit is here. Through our time together, it is our hopes that you will have a better understanding of who we are and our frequency, and about who you are and who your team is.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.